As the VP of Education, I think it's about time I give an educational moment. Before I get started, I have a question for you. How many of you have struggled with getting your name on the list for speaking, to be a speaker for the evening? Anytime in Toastmasters. There's a lot of hands here. That's why I'm here to talk to you tonight. I'm going to talk to you about another role outside of speaking that is just as important. It's a great way to build your leadership skills. It's a great way also to improve your communication skills. And almost every single week, we need it to be filled. And that is the evaluator. We tend to have three or four really great evaluators that always sign up. But I'd like to encourage some of you that haven't done it before to give it a shot. So one thing I'd like to do is share techniques that I have learned through evaluation that have really made it very, very easy. The first step in evaluating is you want to look at the manual, obviously, right? That's where you're going to just quickly read over what it is that a speaker is trying to achieve. Now put it aside. You don't want your speech just to be answering a bunch of questions in that evaluator's manual. Number one, it's extremely boring to listen to. And number two, you're really not going to leave that great impact that we're really trying to make. So what I like to do is I have a full sheet of paper. On the left side, I write things I liked. On the right side, I write things that need to be improved. And I'm really looking at three things. So take notes on this if you haven't given a speech yet, an evaluation yet. The first is the speech organization. I like to look at, is there an intro, a body, a conclusion? Next, I like to look at the mechanics. How's their eye contact? What's their body language like? How about that vocal variety? And finally, I like to look at the speech emotion. This is something any of us can answer. You don't have to be a distinguished Toastmaster. When you're sitting in the audience and you're listening to a speech, how did it make you feel overall? Jot that down. So now, how do we write the speech? You have about 10, 15 minutes. That can be a lot of pressure. This is an easy technique that I use. I look at my likes, I look at my dislikes, I circle the biggest things that I loved. So maybe it's the person weaves a theme throughout the whole entire speech. I put a big star next to that. Then I'll put little stars next to two to three other things that I liked. Then I look on the what needs to be improved. There's a lot of things there. Do we want to give a laundry list of things? If we really want to achieve parity in our evaluation, we want to say something that we would want to hear after we speak. How can we educate and motivate? So I like to look at, if they were to fix one thing, what would that be to make them a better speaker next time? That's it. And then finally, on the delivery, the sandwich approach. You've heard me say it and you've heard me evaluate. I like to start with that big, great thing. I love how you weave the theme throughout your whole entire speech. Then I like to trickle in a couple things I liked based on the manual that they're working against. Your props were great. I sat in the back of the room and I could see them easily. Then I like to throw in that one thing that I feel like if they worked on that, they could really be better. You shift your weight a lot. It was very distracting. If you could work on that, you would be a better speaker. And then finally, I would tell them the organization of your speech was awesome. You had a clear opening, clear body, and a conclusion. So when thinking about giving an evaluation, it's pretty simple. Look at these things and just